हेलो, टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द एंड्रॉयड कंपोनेंट, दैट इज कंटेंट प्रोवाइडर. अ कंटेंट प्रोवाइडर कंपोनेंट सप्लाइज डेटा फ्रॉम वन एप्लीकेशन टू अदर्स ऑन रिक्वेस्ट. वेन एवर टू एप्लीकेशन वॉन्ट टू शेयर डेटा, then content providers comes into picture. Why content providers are necessary? The need for content providers arises because the database created in one application is not visible to a second application. You know the Linux stack is there. Implementation of Android is based on kernel. Therefore, different processes are there, and it is private process for every application. The data is stored for every application. It is not public to other application. It is private. It is not shareable to other application. But two applications want to share data, for example WhatsApp and contacts. WhatsApp accesses contacts from your phone. Then content providers comes into picture. To share the data, content provider provides the data. Here content providers are provided data on request. Such requests are handled by the methods of the content resolver class. A content resolver class comes into picture when the request is there, then content resolver get the request. A content provider can use different ways to store its data, and data can be stored in a database, in files, or even over a network. Three ways are there to store data: database, file, or even over a network. Here, internet means network, SQLite database, or files. Data is stored. Business layer, different applications are there. Content provider, read-write data from internet, SQLite, or files. Here, content providers centralize content in one place and have many different applications access it as needed. Content provider behaves very much like a database. You know the database, different methods are there to perform operations on databases, like insert, update, delete, query. Like database, content provider, you can write your queries using different methods: insert, update, delete, and query methods. In most cases, this data is stored in SQLite database. A content provider is implemented as a subclass of content provider class and must implement a standard set of APIs that enable other applications to perform transactions. Here, to query a content provider, whenever any application want to access data, then that application give request to content provider using content resolver, and then a query a content provider, you can specify the different query string in the form of a URI which has following format. To access data, prefix colon double slash authority data type and ID. This URI is required to access the data. Prefix, this is always set to content colon double slash authority. This specifies the name of the content provider, for example contacts, browser, etc. This is the actual data name of the content provider, authority, who provides the data, that is the authority. And then data type. This indicates the type of data this particular provider provides. For example, if you are getting all the contacts from the contacts content provider, then the data path would be people and URI would look like content, contacts and people. To read the contacts, this is the URI. Content colon double slash contacts people. This an ID, this specifies the specific record requested. Suppose various contacts are stored into contact app, contact database. Then if you want to particular record, you give the number as an ID. Content provider, first we have to create a content provider class that extends the content provider base class. And define your content provider URI address, which will be used to access the content. Next, Android uses SQLite database and frameworks needs to override. You know SQLite database, I already explained what is the SQLite database and what are the crude operations for the SQLite database. Using SQLite open helper method to create or open the provider's database. When your application is launched, the onCreate handler of each of its content providers is called on the main application thread. Then first you have to store the data in SQLite database. Then implement content provider queries to perform different database specific operations. And finally register your content provider in your activity file using provider tag. Here is the list of methods you need to override in content provider class to have your content provider working. Insert, update, delete, query, content provider, and to access data, content URI is there. Insert, update, delete, query method. OnCreate. This method is called when the provider is started. Like database, you use here only content provider for every method. Query, this method receives a request from a client. The result is written as a cursor object. Cursor means record of the table. Insert, this method insert new record in the content provider. Delete content provider, delete existing record, update record, and get type. Here, you have to see one example. Content provider will act as a central repository to store the data of the application in one place and make that data available for different applications to access whenever it's required. From database, it is not possible to access data from one application to another application or file or network. Data is stored by three ways. It stores into database, internet, or file. Whenever one application want to access data from database, internet or file, then content provider provides the data because that data is not sharing in between applications. But using content provider, it can possible to access data from one application to another. Then content provider is a central repository which transfer data from one application to another application securely. Then content provider is a part of an Android application and it will act like a relational database to store the app data. You know the RDBMS or SQL. All the methods are same here. Like databases, we have different types of access permissions available in content provider to share the data. We can set a restrict access permission in content provider to restrict data access limited to only our application, and we can configure different permissions to read or write a data. We can restrict permissions to access data for limited access. We have to restrict the permissions. To access data from content provider, we need to use content resolver object in our application to communicate with the provider as a client. The content resolver object will communicate with the provider object, which is implemented by an instance of a class. In Android, to send a request from UI to content resolver, suppose this is a activity or fragment, it is a UI, and we have another. In Android, to send request from UI to content resolver, we have another object called cursor loader, which is used to run the query asynchronously in background. In Android application, the UI components such as activity or fragment will call a cursor loader to query and get required data from content provider using content resolver. To communicate from UI to content provider, content resolver is there. The content provider object will receive data requests from the client, performs the requested actions, create, update, delete, retrieve, and return the result. This is the pictorial representation of requesting an operation from UI using activity or fragment. To get the data from content provider object, activity or fragment, cursor loader loads the data, and content provider this cursor loader is executed the query for the content. Content provider object will receive data request from the client, performs and then performs the requested action. It executes the query, and content resolver gets the data from content provider using different methods of content provider. Then Android UI application and content provider's interaction will happen to perform the required actions to get data. Content URI, you know, content colon authority and path. Content represent the given URI is a content URI. Name of the content provider, and path represents the table's path. Suppose for example, contacts info, it is the provider and this is the table. Content provider, we need to create a content provider class that extends the content provider base class, and then define our content provider URI to access the content. Content provider class defines 6 abstract methods: insert, update, delete, query, get type, all these methods. And then we need to register our content provider in Android manifest.xml using provider tag. Here query, insert, update, delete, get type and onCreate methods are there. Android content provider, I already implemented that. Here first we have to implement our my content provider KT. How to do that? First we have to create your new application. It will create activity main.xml and main activity.kt. Then you have to create new for content provider dot kt. How to create that? My content provider. Here you have to press new and then other content provider. It will create your my content provider class, and which will contain all the methods which are required for content provider, and we have to override the methods. Here first we have to my content provider dot kt. My content provider, it is extended from content provider. Here companion object we have to define. Companion object means other application can access it, therefore we have to define companion object. Here provider name, suppose our package name is com example dot, therefore I have given com example dot provider. URL content colon dollar provider name, value of this, and table is a users. In main activity dot kt, all the database operations are here. We have to create our own database, and two event handling two buttons are there. For these two buttons, add details and show details. Here first we have to create my content provider database name. URI is required here, and then database name user db, table name users, database version is equal to 1. First you have to create your own database. Create table name and id and name, two fields are there, id and name. Then to handle the your errors, we have to write some code here. URI matcher, no match, then handle that error. Otherwise go ahead, all the methods, get type, on create, query, insert, update, delete, all these methods we have to redefine. You know already how to do that using databases, SQLite databases. You have to implement that methods. Here suppose get type, URI code, this is the path of our table users. If it is correct, then it will go ahead, or otherwise it will create the exception, unsupported URI. Then on create, context class is there, db helper is equal to database helper context. First we have to create our own database, that is database helper class. Database name, database version, SQLite open helper using creating a database. Already you have to give database name, database version, these are the constants. Database name, these are the constant, database name, database version, then it will create a database. Again create database table, execute SQL, create db table. Create db table, we have to store that query into create db table. Create db table is equal to create table, we have to store the query here, and it called that query to create a data table. Then on upgrade, SQLite database, suppose you have to upgrade the version, then you implement this method on upgrade. If you want to drop table, already suppose the table is existed and you want to create that table, then it will drop that table and then again it will create on create db, it will create new table. All the database operations are here and all the methods we have to define. Suppose insert, on create, database helper context, write table database, db is not equal to null true, then else false. Query, here URI projection, four different parameters, 4 to 5 parameters are required here. Sort order, qb is equal to SQLite query builder, qb dot tables. We have to sort the data here. Insert data, db is the database, insert table name and values. Content URIs dot with appended ID, content URI row ID. It will insert one by one. Content resolver dot notify change to insert data. Then SQLite exception. If the operations are not correct, then it will throw exception. Update data, table name, values, selection arguments. These are the parameters. Delete table name, selection, and then all the operations are here like database. No need to explain again because all the you know it is the SQLite database. But it is accessed SQLite like database but for content provider. Using content provider you have to apply all these methods. And content provider requires URI. That is content URI, URI.parse, and URL is the to access table we have to define all these things. Then main activity.kt and then here one button, two buttons are there, insert data and load data. This is the name display for buttons. First you have to insert data and then load data, display data. And text view, one text view, two buttons. And one image view. Text view, it will display after inserting data, it will display remark. Content provider in Android, it is the label. Enter username. Here different as per our design screen Android manifest file we have to give the provider here, provider dot my content provider. This is required thing to execute our program. When you create your my content provider, which I have already told you how to create my content provider class, then it will automatically insert provider into Android manifest file. After executing this program, it shows executing this program, again I will show you. After executing this program, it shows content provider in Android here, activity.main.xml here, linear layout. See the screen. Content provider in Android. This is the title. Then edit text. Enter username. Here we have to provide the string. Enter username. Then button, insert data button is there, and other things are there. Margin button, margin end, margin top, margin start, height, width. On click. On click means after clicking that button, which procedure is there? On click details. You can directly add your on click procedure here, and then from here you can directly goes to your program. On click add details, give the name of method here, and then call that method into your properties for this button. Then it will automatically create code template for the method in your program. Insert data. You can change text color here, appearance, text style. Then another load data. Load data here, match parent, load data center, bold, color, and then text view. Text view is required because after inserting data, suppose I want to insert here name Priya, insert data, it will give new record inserted. This is the text view which is required to display data after inserting. Suppose I want to press, I need to press load data, then it will gives all the data display here, ID and name. Again I want to display insert data, new record inserted. load data, it will display ID and kernel. This is the central repository for content provider. We have to insert data, load data. But how to access data by other application? This data I want to access with other application, then other application, suppose I have developed other application, create your new project. MySCP Access App is the name of my application. Here, design of accessing data of content provider is the title, and load data is the button. Here, code contains linear layout, accessing data of content provider is the title, and one button, load data, and after loading data it will display using text view. Then in main activity, using content provider you can access data of one application to other application. Then when you want to data access from other application, then content URI is required. Here URI.parse content colon com example dot provider slash user. This is the authority to provide the data. Then show details means it will access the data from our application using content resolver. Content resolver dot query URI pass, it take the path of your table, and then access that table from first record and display all the records one by one. It will access get column index, column name ID, and column name. It will access the data and display the data. After executing this program, first of all, three records are there here. After executing this MyCP Access App, accessing data.com content provider, load data, it will again display three records using content resolver class. I hope you will understood all the concepts. What is a content provider? What is a content resolver? And how many methods for the content provider? And what is a URI? And how to access the data from one application to another using content provider. Thank you.